What's going on, everybody? It's your community manager, NAKAT, and today I am here to talk about the Powerpuff Girls joining the MultiVersus roster. They are the newest addition to MultiVersus, and it's not one, not two, but all three of them together as one character. But that doesn't mean that they don't have properties that are unique to themselves. With the Powerpuff Girls' passive ability, Sister Act, the Powerpuff Girls can swap between each other using Down Special. Different leaders apply unique attributes to the trio. Bubbles is fast, but her hits have less knockback. Buttercup is slower, but her hits have more knockback. And Blossom is balanced between the two of them. Different leaders also change the properties of the girl's special moves, so depending on which girl you're using, there is going to be a significant dedicated purpose for using that girl. So now getting into the Powerpuff Girls' normal attacks. The first grounded normal attack we're going to talk about is the Powerpuff Girls' dash attack, which actually has the ability to ring out opponents off of the top. It is a great vertical sending move, and you are able to combo off of this move depending on the opponent's damage. The next move that I'd like to talk about is the Powerpuff Girls side attack. Side attack is a three-hit combo that controls a lot of space and goes pretty far. What I mean by this is, if I use the first one, I am able to connect, right? You see how she kind of lunges forward? However, on the second one, I don't always have to try to land the first one. I can space myself in a way where I hit with the second hit of the move, which then will allow me to still finish into the third hit of the move. Or if I just want to maximize spacing as much as possible, I can hit with the final move as well. Again, this move is very fast. They lunge forward, so it has a lot of range, and it will just strictly knock the opponent back. But you can combo into other options with this move traditionally, like other side attacks in the game as well. So you want to be able to use it in that regard too. Powerpuff Girls' grounded neutral attack allows them to slide on the floor towards an opponent. This not only allows them to duck under certain things, but it is a move that is strong, and depending on which girl you are, will determine how strong the move is. Of course, with Blossom, she has a good balance between both strength and speed. Therefore, you're going to hit the move and you're going to send the opponent flying a bit. Bubbles is a bit weaker, so you're going to notice that the opponent doesn't fly as high when getting hit by this move, and Buttercup sends the opponent the furthest. The Powerpuff Girls' down attack is a good combo starting move that knocks the opponent towards you. It's very fast and will have a lot of use at the ledge when your opponent is trying to come up, or if your opponent has a tendency to roll a lot on the ground, this will be a good move to cover that option. As you can see, the girls slam down the phone and they shoot out towards the opponent, pretty much bringing them in to get comboed vertically. You can either send them vertically again if you want upon landing this move, or you can actually use your forward air or anything that will send them horizontally as well. The Powerpuff Girls' grounded up attack is actually pretty cool. They are able to turn into a grounded tornado, vacuuming the opponent and sending them upward. The awesome thing about this move is not only does it have a lot of range, but it also has the ability to ring out on the top blast zone. And if I was Buttercup in this situation, I would have a much easier time landing that ring out, which of course adds to just how cool it is to be able to have different unique buffs depending on which girl you are controlling at that time. Use this move as a great anti-air tool or even as an approach tool, as you can actually combo into it with a jab. Getting into the Powerpuff Girls' grounded special attacks. Neutral special on the ground allows the Powerpuff Girls to each use a unique ability that has the potential to either ring out an opponent or of course be comboed into. So depending on which one you do, will have pretty much a use that is unique to each girl. The next move I like to talk about is side special on the ground. Side special on the ground has the ability to send out a girl to grab an opponent and actually throw them. If I'm controlling Blossom, Buttercup will be thrown and throw the opponent down. I am able to actually combo off of this because of the ground bounce, and if I want to use this at the ledge, I can throw the opponent downward under the stage to try to set up for an edge guard. If I'm controlling Bubbles and I throw Blossom, Blossom will throw the opponent back towards the girls so that they can combo off of it. And if I am controlling Buttercup and I throw Bubbles, I'm actually able to throw the opponent upward and either ring out off of this, or I can actually just apply more damage depending on how far they go when I throw them, which varies depending on, of course, the opponent's damage percentage. So you want to use this to not only pressure opponents in neutral, but of course to combo off of it as well and set up for ring outs. Something cool is that if you hold this move, the girl will go further. So this is what it looks like if I tap. This is what it looks like if I hold. Much different. Down special allows you to swap between the girls, and this is very important. This is pretty much the core of the character, being able to control all three. But let's talk about a few specifics regarding this mechanic, because there's something cool you can do. So you can actually combo off of this, because when you switch, there is a hitbox at the end of the switch. Now, you're not just gonna run at people and just do this, right? Even though it's great for comboing. So we gotta find utility for this. If we do jab 1-2, we can actually switch right into a girl and throw out an attack, which is really cool. Something also is, if you want to pretty much buffer a special that the next girl has that the current girl doesn't, you can do that as well. So if I just tap neutral special, I get ice breath from Blossom, right? If I double tap, then I press special, I get the sound wave from Bubbles. But what if, as Blossom, I want to buffer immediately into that sound wave from Bubbles? I have to pretty much input down special and immediately tap neutral special. Immediately, there's a timing for it in order for me to get that quick switch into the move. You want to learn this tech, especially if you're going to main the Powerpuff Girls, because it is going to be crucial to getting out quick specials that can actually turn the tides of a match in your favor immediately. The next move I'd like to talk about is the Powerpuff Girls Grounded Up special. The girls launch from the ground into the sky, and this move does have a hitbox, and it is exceptionally good for edge guarding off of the stage, not only because of how active the move is, but of course how fast it is too, with the knockback that it has. So this is Bubbles. That's how high Bubbles goes. If I switch to Buttercup, much shorter, as you can notice. And if I switch to Blossom, it's in between-ish. So you want to make sure that you know which girl you're using, so you know how high you're going and how much damage or knockback you will be dealing. This move has the ability to hit people vertically, but also knock people a bit horizontally or diagonally. So get very used to how this move functions off stage, because it's going to be a very important tool, not only for your recovery, but for your ability to edge guard. For the Powerpuff Girls aerial specials, they are pretty much the same thing as they are on the ground. So you just want to be able to use these in the same way. However, I'm going to talk about one of them that is much different. So in the air, right? If I use side special, as you can see, the girls shoots at a girl just like on the ground, but you actually zoom to them as well. This one actually cannot be charged, but it is a good horizontal recovery option that also has the ability to knock the opponent back. Now, the thing is that, did you see that trajectory? If I am controlling Blossom, just like on the ground, I would throw Buttercup. The opponent goes at a downward diagonal angle. Now, I know that you guys are understanding what that means for offstage edge guarding. If an opponent gets hit by this and knocks them at a weird angle, that allows you to go off and try to continue to pressure them off stage. If I am Buttercup and I shoot Blossom, the opponent is going to go forward, not towards you, because we don't want to bring them back, right? This is meant to be aggressive offstage edge guarding. Now, Buttercup and I throw Bubbles, the opponent will go upward on connection. So this is a good move, not only for offense, but of course to recover back to the stage if using your up special just isn't enough. Aerial down special functions the same. You're going to switch girls, but they're able to combo off of this in the air as well upon connection, and of course use it to ladder opponents to the top blast zone. So it's a combo tool, it's a utility tool for switching between girls, and it exerts a ton of pressure, because look at how big this move actually is. And lastly, we are going to talk about the Powerpuff Girls aerials, and this is where things get a little bit different than on the ground. So as y'all saw with the Rainbow Dash perk, we're able to do a dash attack in the air. I do not have it currently equipped, so I'm not able to do that. So my forward aerial is coming out. Forward aerial allows the girls to pretty much form a horizontal ladder that knocks away the opponent. This move has a lot of range, it's fast, and it is used not only to approach, but it is also used, of course, to keep opponents away. You are able to hit the girls because they are still, they still have a hurt box throughout the entire character during this move. So It is a hitbox and a hurtbox. If you do just throw this out over and over and over, there is a chance that you will be punished, so make sure you are throwing it out with purpose. Next move I like to talk about is the Powerpuff Girls Neutral Aerial. So, Neutral Air is a large move. As you can see, it's a bit different than the dash attack on the ground where it's smaller, but they're doing a cartwheel. The girls are holding hand in hand, going in a circular motion that you are able to actually hit the opponent with and combo off of as well. You can get really creative because this not only is an approach tool, as I just shown you, it is a combo tool as well. So use this move not only to approach, but of course you can use it out of other attacks as well if deemed necessary. The next move I'd like to talk about is the Powerpuff Girls Downward Aerial Attack. Downward air is a thrust downward between all three girls to knock the opponent down to the bottom blast zone. You of course can use this on stage to trigger a ground bounce, that way you're able to combo off of that as well. This move is super good in the fact that it's very fast, it's very strong, and of course it just has reliable setup power, so whether your opponent's at mid percent or of course they're at high percent, they will be taking a lot of damage. And the last aerial that we're going to be talking about is the Powerpuff Girls Upward Aerial. So the upward aerial is just a singular quick strike that sends the opponent upward. I want to say that the move has decent range because the Powerpuff Girls, as you can see, even though they have all this power, they're a little bit stubby regardless. And so with this move, it is not like the grounded variant that has the tornado vacuum hitbox. So unlike its grounded counterpart, it does not have the vacuum tornado. It is just a singular strike, but it still has enough damage to ring out opponents, and it is still a good option not only for approaching in the air, but of course for trying to land ring outs from the top. So lastly, let's talk about the Powerpuff Girls perks and how they work. Something that makes them unique is that they are one of the only characters in the game that can now do an aerial dash attack with the perk Rainbow Dash. Use this move not only to knock away opponents, but of course you can use it as an approach option, and depending on where they DI, you will be able to combo off of the move. The next move is called an extra ingredient. What this move does is it changes the properties of their neutral specials. So their neutral specials by themselves are really cool. You can combo off of them. Some can ring out opponents. They're dope. But what if I told you that extra ingredient actually adds debuffs to the opponent? For instance, if I use Blossoms, it actually adds stacks of freeze. But if I use Bubbles, it will stun the opponent. And if I use Buttercup, if you actually just trigger the laser, it is a strong attack that can actually ring out the opponent, or has the potential to ring out the opponent. But of course, with an extra ingredient, you're actually able to apply Ignite to an opponent, making them take damage over time. So it has the utility of both being super strong, but also of course applying a debuff, which is really useful. The Powerpuff Girls are a very quick, explosive character, but I do believe that they are one of the more technical characters in the game, so they will take time to master at a very high level. However, they do have options that make them welcoming to newcomers that will allow you to play them even if you don't really have too much of a technical grasp on the game yet, but you just want to play your favorite character. It is so awesome to see all three of them in MultiVersus together, and we are so happy to have them a part of the official roster. We hope you love this character. I think this character is not only awesome, but one of the stronger characters in the game, and I cannot wait to see what combos all of the players come up with the Powerpuff Girls. This is NAKAT, your community manager over at Player First Games. Please let me know in the comment section below what you think of the Powerpuff Girls. Will you be maining them? And what character, not only do you want to see a god for next, but what character do you want to see in MultiVersus next? Take it easy. Please subscribe to the channel. Have a great one.